Hello, my name is Mughi Shital and my topic is sedative and hypnotics. Let us see the SAR of benzodiazepines. Firstly, see the structure of benzodiazepines. First point is the presence of a electron attracting substituents, that is chlorine, fluorine, bromine and the nitro group at position 7 is required for activity. And the more electron attracting leads to more activity. Then the second point is position 6, 8 and 9 should not be substituted. Third one is the presence of phenyl or pyridyl at the fifth position increases as activity and all benzodiazepines has this substituent. Then 5 phenyl ring with electron attracting, generally halogen atom groups at the 2 or 2,6 position shows greatly increased activity. On the other hand, substitution in 3, 4 and 5 decreases activity. Example, lorazepam, midazolam and triazolam. Then almost all benzodiazepines except those possessing a fused heterocyclic ring or a thionyl group have a carbonyl group at position 2. Next point is the N substituent at position 1 should be small for high intrinsic activity. Then derivatives with additional rings, that is triazole, imidazole, joining the diazepam nucleus at the first and second positions are generally active. Example, triazolam, alprazolam. Then the next point is reduction of carbonyl function at the second position to CH2 gives less potent compounds. Then replacement of the benzene ring by heteroatomic, that is thiophene ring, resulted in enhanced anxiolytic properties. Let us see the clinical uses of benzodiazepines. Benzodiazepines offer improved therapeutics and are well tolerated for the following conditions. First one is calm the body. Second one is insomnia. Third one is adjuncts to anesthesia to induce relaxation and amnesia. Fourth one is to reduce anxiety. Fifth one is panic disorders. And the last one is to treat or prevent seizures. Now, let us see the adverse effects, which are drowsiness, dizziness and decreased alertness and concentration. These are the references. Thank you.